Welcome to sunny Malta, to the Malta Eurovision Song Contest 2017. With us now, we have the big pleasure to welcome the hosts of the show. It is Daniel Azzopardi and Charlene Mercieca. I think that's the way to say it. Hello, how are you guys?
Hi, you're right.
Great meeting you, and we send our greetings, obviously, to all our viewers.
So you're the host of this biggest show of Malta.
Yes.
So how does that feel for you?
Especially when they gave us, when they told us it's 92% of the population here actually see this show.
Like, it was quite an experience. It's quite an experience for us. Until you're involved in it, you don't realize how big it is as an event. So it's an honor for us and a privilege to be part of this event.
Yes.
Have we been working together previously?
No.
It's never met before.
No, never. But we clicked.
Immediately, yeah.
Fantastic. You're very lively people. So I start with Daniel. You are an actor as well,
yes.
I understand. Tell me a little bit about it.
Yes, I've been involved in quite a few television series in Malta, which were quite popular. And at the moment, I'm acting in Strada Stretta, which is also quite popular TV series on Television Malta.
And we know last year's host, Ben, comes from there too. Fantastic.
Yes, Ben is also a co-star of the show. We have a couple of scenes together as well, so yeah.
So, if it's been last year, this year it's you. Who is going to be coming next year from Strada Stretta to host it?
Well, there are quite a few candidates. I wouldn't bet on anyone because they're all very good candidates, I guess. So.
It's like a Malta Eurovision Song Contest hosting camp, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it's a hosting camp. Exactly, it is.
Charlene, let's talk about you a little bit. What is your background in Malta?
Well, basically, I'm technically nowadays as a soap maker, literally and truly, humble roots. I studied as a beauty therapist. I always have a lot of creativity, and basically my job had already captured a lot of the attention, local attention as well. I've been on TV on many shows for the past 8 years, so you know my face is quite because of my job. But lately it has shifted a bit to another kind of in another way. Last year I was diagnosed with breast cancer, and basically I started journaling about it, and this caught quite a lot of attention, and from there I became a bit of a, how can I say this?
Of like leading example, basically, because you're very energetic and in a happy mood in a way.
Yes, that's what they say. So they say that I'm a positive person, apparently.
You are. I can vouch for that. So.
But yes, it's something which, obviously, I was always a happy-go-lucky gal, but this experience kind of teaches you a lot to kind of enjoy the moment. We tend to live a lot in the past or in the future, but we very, very little live in the present moment, and that's for us is for me it was a big revelation almost, and now I'm enjoying this experience as well in presenting. It was always a dream to actually present a program like this, but this was a bit, I didn't take baby steps. Yeah,
wasn't really a stepping, I wouldn't call this as a stepping stone.
It was a stepping rock. A stepping what?
Starting from top and then going and...
Wow.
So yes, and a beautiful experience for us.
It's the biggest show in Malta that's coming out here, after the soap opera, of course. So have you any Eurovision background, what do you know about the Eurovision Song Contest?
Well, here in Malta, even if you don't want to, you end up in the whole experience of checking and seeing what's happening with Eurovision. It's kind of a journey which starts, early in the year.
As you and whether you are a fan or not a big fan, you still watch it. It's just like that. You have the big fans who also travel with the
entourage,
the whole entourage and everything. And then you have also those which are fan for just the gossip and the...
It's like a meeting point, really. Mm-hmm. Like families here meet up to see the Eurovision and they use it as an occasion to get to know new relatives.
And every outlet and restaurant will have big screens.
So it's
kind of
an event in itself.
It's public viewing of the Eurovision Song Contest. Excellent. Fantastic.
That's beautiful. Exactly. Yeah, you go out anywhere and you see people watching the Eurovision. So.
From the past, in the history of Eurovision Song Contest, in Malta, the Maltese selection, have you any favorites there?
I had one. I told you.
Yeah, she did. Listen to her, because because I had quite a few who were very interesting in their own way.
Okay.
Quite interesting. So
but yes, I like Gianluca. The song was Tomorrow. Yes,
fantastic.
I like his. He's a nice smile, nice going.
So very nice personality himself. So.
Well, we just get a signal that you have to go onto the rehearsal now to do your job, basically.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for talking to us. We wish you all the best of luck, Charlene.
For the health process, that it goes
well. For Saturday, have fun and enjoy this whole experience.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.